I see that you want to talk and tell us where she is. I know you know. I can tell by looking at you.
Cet homme est tombé dans le piège de la police lors de cet interrogatoire qui a fait le tour du monde et il a accidentellement avoué tout ce qu'il avait fait subir à sa femme des dizaines d'années auparavant. C'est en novembre 1981 qu'Evelyn Mackay a mystérieusement disparu sans laisser de traces. À l'époque, son mari avait affirmé qu'elle était partie dans l'Ohio. Cependant, il a rapidement donné plusieurs versions contradictoires sur ce qui s'était passé, ce qui a alimenté les soupçons à son égard. Faute de preuves, l'affaire a finalement été classée sans suite, mais contre toute attente, elle allait connaître son issue finale plus de 30 ans après les faits.
Do you remember the day she left?
No.
I'm trying to think what was it.
Come on.
Work with me here, buddy.
Go
I can't even remember what I ate for supper yesterday.
The day she came up missing, were you at work or what?
I don't have any clue.
When she left?
I'm going to validate these interviews. And you're making it hard on me. I thought we'd be in and out of here in about 45 minutes. Well, this is going a little further.
Le policier venait tout juste d'entamer cet interrogatoire, mais sa patience commençait déjà à s'épuiser. Et très vite, tout est devenu plus tendu entre les deux hommes.
Well, you know what? I have a confession.
I was in a case went to cold case, which is us, and it's been put together. And it's coming. It's coming. And
what?
I just
what?
You're fixing to be charged with this.
Charged with what?
The death of Laverne Mackay.
L'officier faisait face à un mur. Il avait besoin de preuves pour pouvoir inculper Mackay, alors il a mis au point une stratégie. Il lui a dit que ce qui s'était passé pouvait avoir été un accident, et que tout n'était peut-être pas de sa faute. Il espérait ainsi qu'il avouerait absolument tout, ce qui a fini par fonctionner à merveille.
Did I tell you that I like to go fishing?
Yes,
you did.
Okay. I went fishing at the English. Mm-hmm. She fell at the dock, hit her head, fell in the water. Mm-hmm. I have been back there 100 times, raving about that deal, that I didn't jump in the water to save her. I've been living with this for 32 years. I was scared they'd think that I killed her. Why didn't you call for help and say, hey, she's in the water?
Her head was bleeding pretty bad. She was not breathing.
The body in the water, especially that one, it doesn't go away.
I put some weight on her to take her bottom down. When I roped that rope around that woman and watched her sink, it's never gone away. It was an accident.
You telling me the truth right now?
Will you? I'm telling you, this is a straight business.
Marilyn, you're picking her up.
I just took her clothes.
And you're pulling her and you're taking her up out of the water? Did you lift her back up onto the dock?
No, because she was, I mean, blood was just squirting out.
30 ans après la disparition d'Evelyn Mackay, la terrible vérité venait enfin d'être découverte. C'est ainsi que son mari a été condamné à 10 ans de prison pour homicide au second degré.